America has lost its innocence.
There are some things that have happened in America which is causing it today to be a country of one of deterioration.
Somehow I think we've forgotten about religion and we've distorted the truth.
The Quran comes as a final book. There will be no other books, but it also is a verifier. And it clarifies other scriptures that came previous, because they were revelations before this one. And this is the final revelation. So no other revelation will be needed, no other book will come.
So you have the Muslim who has a faith in Mecca, which also brings and embraces Muhammad, Muhammadism, and with as an argument on the timetable. Okay, whether it's the Chronos or the Kairos, they look at a particular period where they believe that actually theirs is the oldest. Where my persuasion is, Christianity is the oldest. Historical accounts of what take place, and that causes a strong persuasion in my own heart as well as in my own mind and my own spirit to embrace the biblical truth of 66 books, which was canonized, if you will, from what I learned, even at seminary level, from what they've gotten off of what they call the Dead Sea Scrolls.
The law is the law, the Torah is the Torah. What's important in Judaism is how we live every single day, rather than what's going to happen when the Moshiach, when the Messiah comes.
Now, the Jews, and those who don't accept Christ as Messiah or Messiah, they have a view that there is one coming. Now, that can get into the era of eschatology, eschatos, which is eschaton, end time things and things to come.
Forms of religious beliefs or principles, but I would say under those three, you have found more progress for society and humanity than any other.
There's a fight between Israelis and Palestinians, that it's not the Jewish religion that is being fought against. Although I would say that a lot of the rhetoric that we've seen coming out of the Arab world, a lot of the rhetoric we read in the newspaper, has taken medieval Christian anti-Jewish sentiments and reused them in a modern sense. So when one says they're anti-Zionist, They're not against Jews per se. I find that that's sort of a euphemism for being anti-Semitic in these days and times.
The term holy war and jihad is something that has its origins from the media because it sells newspapers and it also heightens hysteria. Now, there is something. Tumult and oppression is worse than death. And I do believe that the Palestinian people have been put into a corner. And I believe any one of us that's put into a corner because the first law of nature comes into play, and that is self-preservation. And they're only striving to preserve themselves, even though it's inappropriate, in a sense, to take the life of another individual by taking your life.
First of all, Israel's truly the main ally that the U.S. has in the Middle East. Also, the Jewish community in the United States feels very supportive of having a Jewish state. And the Jewish community is very supportive of America. We have an ally, we have a friend, we have information from both countries, whether it's technological, whatever it is, the resources both countries have to help each other a lot. So absolutely, I feel that this is a relationship that's imperative to continue cultivating.
I believe that any nation, anywhere and everywhere that will support Israel is going to be blessed. It often says throughout the Psalm and the Psalter about praying for Israel.
Israel came Prophet Muhammad through the line of Isaac came Jesus, Solomon, Jacob, Job, David, and some of the other prophets or messengers that came to society or civilization. I don't know if it's looked upon as a fight between the two brothers or not.
Abraham is considered to be the father of the Israelites, and Abraham's considered by Islam to be father of the Muslims. So if we look back and see that we all have the same ancestors, then we should be treating each other as though, you know, just going back to the Bible.
We need to be careful in the United States to not be partial toward either, but see what we can do to support both of them in the process of reconciliation. Because the Jews in themselves are very serious about this statement of the possibility of them being annihilated.
I don't believe that any people should have to be subjugated or held in an oppressive situation, wherever it is in the world. Jihad means war, yes, but struggle more so than war.
I was disturbed to make the connection that the relationship of the United States to Israel is what prompted this terroristic attack.
We welcome the inquiries, but not under these circumstances.
I believe that people are starting to look to a creator. They are beginning to open their eyes to the reality that death is certain and that death can happen at any moment.
We know that the taking of innocent lives of human beings is forbidden, and for us to do that, it puts us outside the pale of Islam. It puts us really at war with our creator because we have done something which he has instructed us not to do. I'm not saying that Muslims, we are pacifists. No, we're not pacifists. We are not pacifists in the sense that we will let you continually just come and be the aggressor. We have the right to fight.
We have now experienced as Americans what Israel is experiencing on a daily basis with terrorism.
Every day. that we're breathing and living, we're moving closer and closer to the time when Christ is going to come. And of course, everybody, even sinners and pagans, and that's the question of all questions to be asked. That's the million-dollar question. Is it now or when? I think since September 11, people have stepped at the ante, if you will, and start to believe now. It could be very close, and it could be very far off. But I think that there are signs in the seasons that begin to tell us that as believers, we need to draw nigh to God as He draws nigh to us, and He is on His way back.
Unlike Christianity, which I believe Jesus is the Messiah, we don't believe in Jesus as the Messiah. So as far as Judaism is concerned, you know, there has not been a Messiah.
Jesus is the Messiah. That was one of the names that was given Him, the Messiah.
We're still waiting for the Messiah. Whether that's an individual person or a messianic time, none of us know. We haven't experienced this.
No one knows the hour that God will call all of this and all of us to account. But yet and still, we know that that hour will come.
Everyone that really has placed their faith in Jesus is secure.
Do discuss the eternality of the soul. So the body might die and the soul continues. But I truly don't know.
Only the Father, Abba God, only Yahweh God, knows the time and the hour when Christ will come.